I want to do research that affects people's daily lives and finds a way to make those lives better.
I got into this profession because one professor really took the time to tell me that I had the ability. If it hadn't been for this professor when I was an undergraduate, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be here today.
It's evident that the faculty really care. They're here because they want to be.
I always tell the students that if all they've learned in the class is theory, then I've failed as a teacher. To me, it's all about application, their ability to apply these things out in the real world.
I'm actually seeing how these students digest the research, how they interact with it, and how they live it out.
It's amazing to see the commitment in front of the classroom, and I think it comes very naturally to most of the professors here because they're so passionate about what they're actually talking about.
We have a faculty that is all doing pretty significant work on research issues all over the board.
I go to Washington about every 2 months for a few days at a time, and I spend time at the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, and we've been working a lot on things like disclosures. It's always very satisfying to be there and to feel like the work is getting in front of these audiences where it can really make a difference.
I'm particularly excited about this because it's tools that financial educators can use to actually help people make smarter saving decisions and better debt repayment decisions. It could potentially affect hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of people.
More than any other academic institution that I've ever spent time in, Anderson faculty really don't care about disciplinary boundaries.
I'm sitting in a place with some of the essentially brightest research minds in academia who I can just knock on a door and get feedback from right away. That says something about the collaboration and says something about sort of the raw intellectual horsepower that we have here too.
I'm extremely proud of what we're doing on the teaching innovation front. One is the co-teaching model, where a professor like me is teamed up with an executive like Harry Sloan, who's the former chairman CEO of MGM, and we teach every session together.
So how do we recruit the best faculty resources?
Many other top institutions, business schools, there actually are no endowed chairs for teaching in particular. And I think that it actually speaks to one of the priorities of Anderson. Here we really care about teaching.
An endowed chair gives me the resources to continue to do my research, to support PhD students, to continue in the research endeavor.
So we have those things that will attract the faculty, and then it's just a question of having the resources to get them here.
At Anderson, I feel like my work and my teaching have merged so much closer than they ever have at any institution before.
This is a place where people care about making the world a better place, and this is why I want to be here for the rest of my career.
If I could have the same impact on one or a few students that this professor had on my life, that would be greatly rewarding.